The population of downtown Des Moines increased by 150 people the past few months as the 82nd Iowa General Assembly convened at the state capitol. Now that the 2008 legislative session is adjourned, what did it all mean for education in Iowa? We'll talk with a key legislator next on Classroom Connections. Hi, and welcome to Classroom Connections, a public affairs discussion on issues important to students, teachers, and parents in Des Moines Public Schools. I'm Phil Roeder, Director of Community Relations. Public education in Iowa relies on a partnership between state government and local school districts. This means that decisions made under the Gold Dome impact schools from one end of Iowa to the other. Here today to talk with us a little bit more about this is a very special guest, former member of the Des Moines School Board who now represents a part of our city in Des Moines, State Representative Ako Abdul-Samad. Thanks very much for coming back to Des Moines Public Schools.
Good to be here, Phil. It's good to be on your show.
Well, it's great to have you. Yeah, as we were talking about before the show, you are our first non-school district guest that we've had on Classroom Connections. So you've marked a milestone for this show.
Breaking new ground now.
Always good to do. Let's talk a little bit about your experience, first of all, as a school board member and now a legislator. How'd that transition work? Did being on a school district board of directors help give you any insight or perspective now that you're addressing education issues on a statewide basis?
It did. It gave me a background. It gave me a foundation, to look at what needed to be done, from the state level. One of the problems that we had, and I want to thank you because I actually came under you and Connie and Mark as the board chairs. But the thing is, it helped me to see that where to put emphasis on and importance and where money needed to go, because of what we were trying to do, during the 3 years I was on the school board itself. I just got to say, though, I'm still kind of still disappointed because we're still not on the getting the books that we need and the material that we need yet, and we need to get some money to our districts to catch us up, on that level, without a doubt.
Well, that's good. You're obviously in a key spot at the legislature as a member of the House Education Committee. You just recently finished up the session. From your perspective, what are some of the highlights for education that you addressed this year?
Well, I think the point of course, and we'll talk about that as we go on to silo tax. I think to the point the teachers pay. I think to the fact that we're talking about core curriculum. Those are some of the highlights when we look at education. I think we're better off than where we were, but we still have a long way to go. But I think that's where the focus. I even to the point that we're talking on a state level about parent involvement, the academic achievement gap, those type of things that we actually talked about and looked at. Phil Wise, Representative Phil Wise, who retired this year, actually introduced a bill to where individual school districts would look at students starting in like the eighth grade, where they were at academically. Were they meeting their core courses? Did they have enough so that when you project, could they graduate? That type of thing. So those are some of the highlights, I believe.
Okay. Let's come back to the statewide sales tax for a minute. It's been talked about now for a few years. Of course, over the last 10 years, every county in Iowa has passed their own local option tax. But while it's been talked about for the last few years, it was only this year that all of a sudden it seemed to be a real groundswell of bipartisan support in both the House and Senate to pass this. What do you think was different this year? Why is a statewide sales tax for school infrastructure now reality?
Well, I think two reasons. One, I believe that people have reprioritized. The priority is to really focus on what we need to do to better our schools, not just academically, but create a environment that individuals can learn in. Our schools needed help. The second thing, it was our priority as the Democratic Party. This is one of our wish lists that came to fruition, mm-hmm. you know, because we needed to focus in on it, and then it became, you know, bipartisan, you know, because everybody realized in rural communities and urban communities, we needed better schools, we needed infrastructure, you know, and you can see that. I love Carver, George Washington Carver, you know, you look at that, that's to me a model school that could be replicated across this country.
Well, I was going to say, you mentioned Carver, and of course you have a lot of Des Moines public schools in your district. Yeah. Some of them have been renovated under the current local option tax, but there's several that were not going to receive any funds whatsoever under the current tax. What do you tell your constituents about the new legislation? What do you tell them this is going to mean for them, for their neighborhoods, for their kids?
Well, I focus on the fact that don't look at it as a penny being added to the sales tax. You know, don't look at it as it going into a fund and is what district's going to get how much money. Look at it to the point that we're talking about investment, you know, with our young people. You know, we are facing some global challenges, you know, in preparing young people for the global market, you know, for competitive, you know, that type of thing. I mean, you look at what's going on in China, you look at what's going on in Japan and Korea, you know, our third world countries, you know, we fall behind, you know, so this is an investment to bring us up, you know, to speed, you know, so that we prepare our leadership.
I want to follow up on another issue you touched on. I know it's something that's been important to you long before you were in the legislature or even on the school board, which is the role of parents in academic achievement. I know there's some local initiatives that are about to get underway that you're very supportive of and I think excited about. Tell us a little bit about that.
I'm very excited. I really am. I'm elated because you have community people working with the Des Moines School District. And when you have that type of partnership, you know, then you're looking at reaching out and getting parents involved. You know, you have the Brain Trust that's being headed by Paulette Wiley and others that are setting up a series of community summits that's supported by the Des Moines, you know, Public School District. Our superintendent, you and others who have been actively involved with that, you know, are being able to reach out to parents and show them why they need to be involved. Because no matter if we do the silo tax, the penny tax, we even bring our books up to date, our, you know, learning materials up to date, we do it. That doesn't have the impact without that component of parent involvement. Parents have to get involved. And involvement doesn't mean just coming to PTA. Involvement may be just making sure your child gets their homework done. Involvement may mean just calling the school. So that's why I'm elated, you know, about this initiative that's taking place.
Good. It's going to be a great effort from everything we've seen and looking forward to seeing the results. Let's look ahead just a little bit to next year. It'll be here before we know it, another legislative session. What are some of the issues that you think are still on the table? What are some of the things that you hope to be able to address and future legislatures will address when it comes to education in Iowa?
I would like to really see us focus on standards. I would like to see us focus on teacher pay, where we went from 42 to 25. I would like to see us go from 25 to 15 or even 10. Mm-hmm. You know, I would like to see us address that as we go along. I would like to see us invest more money in, again, giving in technology. You know, I think we need to focus on technology. That's where it's at today. Mm-hmm. You know, and I don't think we're putting enough money there. You know, even to the point, I still have this little pet peeve, you know, about us equipping our students, especially high school students, you know, with laptops, you know, or some type of technology that allows them to not only learn in school, but learn at home if they're sick and that type of thing. I think with technology today, a teacher could teach better if we equip our students. Instead of them getting a laptop when they hit college, they should have one in high school. And I think we need to look at how do we fund technology so our schools can do that. You know, I think it gives our students, you know, not even a heads up, I think it catches us up with the rest of the world.
Okay, a lot of good work left to be done.
Yeah.
So, well, thank you, Representative Abdul-Samad, for taking the time to talk with us today. And we'll have to have you back again, maybe before the legislative session next time, to talk about what issues are what we're going to look forward to.
Well, I look forward to it, and thank you for letting me be the first to break the new ground.
Well, good. Our pleasure, absolutely. Yeah. So, well, if that's all the time we have today, thanks for watching. Until next time, for Classroom Connections, I'm Phil Roeder.